Well, it's day two of the trip down to Phetchaburi province. Today we're coming to Kaeng Krachan National Park, just starting to explore off the road a little bit in some area that is quite flooded, a lot of water here. I've only previously come to this park in February, March, April time when it's very dry. This is the end of the rainy season now, and it's very interesting to see. The habitat is really different, it's very lush. And there's water everywhere, a lot of footprints, gaur footprints and deer footprints that we can see. And we're going to spend the day exploring in this park.
Our first find of the day, a troop of stump-tailed macaques. Many people will have seen macaques in Thailand, but this is not one of the species that is seen so often. Okay. Look at that tiny little newborn running into the side, wonderful. I didn't stop because macaques can get used to that, and that can lead to all kinds of problems. Our first snake of the day, a lovely Oriental whip snake.
Is it normally the green form?
Yeah, here we only get green ones.
Oh, really?
But the yellow ones are brown, but they don't see.
All right.
But you have a bit like two kinds of green, like this one, very bright.
Yeah.
So get a bit, one that's a bit more towards bluish.
Oh, okay. He's doing the thing with the tongue there, that's so cute.
Yeah. Ones, yeah, they have a, almost the albolabus-like tail, red with green.
Uh-huh.
But very long.
And now our second Oriental whip snake of the day, another adult, lovely green color, going slowly across the road. We always drive very, very slowly when we are in wildlife sanctuaries and national parks for very good reason. There's often snakes on the road, and I find it incredibly frustrating when I see cars driving fast in these parks.
Okay, so we found this lovely whip snake. I call them whip snakes, some people call them vine snakes. On the road here, we're gonna clear it off the road because there is a bit of traffic. Here you can see it's a little bit stressed out with me holding it like this, and the scales coming out on the upper part of the body and the neck there, showing a bit of different color, some white, beautiful pale bluish green tongue poking out there. I just love the eyes of this snake, the keyhole pupil it's called, really beautiful. Okay, we're gonna let it go on the side, let it go about its way, free from traffic. Okay, good stuff.
And our third Oriental whip snake, enjoying a bit of sun on the side of the road in a low bush. And if I'm not mistaken, I think that's an Oriental pied hornbill calling in the background. If I am mistaken, please leave a comment.
Beautiful coloration on this young Oriental whip snake. And the color, probably, certainly, what would you say? Gonna just change to green as he gets older.
Yeah.
Okay, the ones in this area. There are different color forms of this snake, but the ones in this park are always a shade of green when they're older. But this is a young one, it's a beautiful color. I don't even know what you would call that. What would you call that, gray olive?
Sure.
Okay, nice, nice.
Yeah, excellent.
Oh!
Gorgeous.
Feisty.
All blue.
Okay, it's time to go to bed for this snake, I think. So back he goes where it belongs.
And now an extraordinary phenomenon which is happening here at Bang Krang campsite in Kaeng Krachan. Most days, this sun bear coming out of the forest looking for food at the back of the kitchen area here at the campsite. The son of one of my friends there in Thai, just letting everybody know that the bear is here. I've previously seen civets and porcupines coming to find scraps of food here at the back of the kitchen, but this is something very, very different. Bye-bye.